I want to share a story with you. A story about a city where AI has become a powerful, helpful, life-changing part of the society. In the classrooms, the students don't need to read through boring old books anymore. They can jump into the latest and most exciting AI apps and get quick and accurate summaries in seconds. All that time they save, they can spend with their friends. Nice. In company offices, business teams don't need to hold long and boring brainstorming sessions to come up with their ideas. AI can predict future market trends and even plan out their strategies for them. And in the libraries, historians don't spend long days in hot basement rooms looking over dusty old scrolls to try and understand confusing cultures. They can use AI on their phone, scan and analyze for meaning, and get answers to all the questions they could possibly have without even breaking a sweat. Now, I bet you're thinking, wow, this city sounds great. Things run smoothly, things get done on time, grades are good. Sounds pretty efficient to me. Well, I want to challenge that thought. Because to tell the truth, even though this city sounds perfect, something's missing. Something really important for our growth and our success. But what could possibly be missing? My name is Robert Stroud, and I'm a professor based in Japan. And the reason I'm here today is simple. I'm here to talk to you about a missing piece in our AI-driven lives that is truly important for our growth and our success. We're becoming mesmerized by AI's capabilities, and this terrifies me. It terrifies me as a teacher, as a parent, as a member of today's society. I hear everyone asking, what can AI do now? How fast can it work? How much does that new app cost? Can it do this homework for me? Will my boss know if AI wrote my reports? And none of these questions really matter until we start asking more important ones first. Is AI going to give me more control of my future or start controlling me? Is AI going to push me to become the best I can or make me take shortcuts? And am I going to get smarter with AI or less able to think and solve problems? Now, here's the thing. The answer to these questions isn't in the hands of AI. It's in yours. You're in control. You decide. Now picture this. There's a second city. Let's call this one City 2. And City 2 is a lot like the first city, City 1. AI has made life faster, more effective, more productive. But City 2's got something extra. Let's see if you can guess what it is. So in City 2, in the science labs, data gets processed much, much faster with AI, but the scientific breakthroughs still come because of human curiosity. In the art classrooms, students use AI to refine their visions, but their final creations still remain very human, full of love and feeling and emotion that no machine can ever really understand. And in the business schools, young entrepreneurs harness AI to optimize their business strategies, but the real ideas, the bold ideas, the risk-taking, the real innovation still belongs to the humans. So what is this thing we're seeing in City 2? What is this secret ingredient? Well, I'll tell you. Struggle. City 2 has got the perfect relationship between the human and the machine. The human struggles, and AI just helps them over the finish line. City 2 isn't run by AI. It's powered by the minds that are using it. AI doesn't dictate choices. It opens possibilities by pushing people further than ever before. No struggle, no growth. So what does a struggle look like? Okay, Well, let's think about a real example. Let's think about a classroom. So let's go back to City 1, and let's walk into a creative writing class. And we found a student named Mike. Hey, Mike. And Mike is working on his very own story. But he doesn't need to sit and write and rewrite lots of long and boring and useless ideas. He doesn't need to brainstorm which idea works best, develop a complicated plot, and make all these long and tiring decisions. Mike can use AI on his phone to get some really great creative ideas. He asks AI, write me a story about an adventure in space, something my teacher and all my friends will love to read. And in seconds, voila, AI generates a full story complete with interesting characters, a great beginning, middle, and end. Really good stuff, actually, something you'd all enjoy reading. Mike hands it in. He gets a good grade. He's happy. His teacher's happy. The university's happy. Life is good. Or at least it seems that way. The next week, Mike's teacher, Mr. Johnson, calls him to his office. Now, if you were there with Mike when he opened that door, you'd notice the smell of old books in the air and see all the old brown leather furniture around the room. And Mr. Johnson says, Mike, that story you wrote last week was great. I want you to write a sequel. This thing could be big. Come on in and sit down. Here's some pen and paper. Get started with some ideas. I'll be back to help soon. And Mr. Johnson leaves. So Mike sits down in that brown leather chair and he freezes. Nothing comes to mind. He's just staring at those blank sheets. He can't even remember the first story he said he wrote. The room starts to feel hot. Mike starts feeling himself sticking to that brown leather chair. And the clock on the wall is ticking louder and louder. Mike's starting to worry. He's worrying about his grades, his future. And he asks himself, can I do this? Mike wants to write these ideas down. But he can't. Why? Because he skipped the most important part in that first story. He skipped the thinking part, the struggle, and he's got nowhere to go from here. No struggle, no growth. So what happens next to Mike? Well, Mr. Johnson comes back to the room and sees the blank sheets. Mike confesses all. He tells Mr. Johnson how he didn't write the story that AI did. He's completely honest with him. And what does Mr. Johnson do? Well, he doesn't get mad, much to Mike's surprise. He listens, and they sit together, and they talk about what to do next. And Mike decides he wants to give this another shot. He wants to write a story. So he writes some ideas down, and he pitches them to Mr. Johnson. Some are pretty good. Mr. Johnson gives him some feedback and even shows Mike how to use AI on his phone to get more feedback at home. And Mr. Johnson shares his own story with Mike, too, how he, too, had struggled and failed time and time again in his own life and found out the hard way that struggle is actually our friend. Mike goes home, and he keeps working on his story. Some of the feedback from AI he likes, other feedback, not so much. And he struggles for a few days, and he completes his very own story. He takes it back to the university and hands it in, this time with a real sense of ownership. This time, Mike had the perfect balance with AI, and he feels really proud of the story that he wrote. In fact, Mike was so inspired by this whole experience, he decided to leave City 1 and move to City 2, where he went on to become a world-famous author, writing great story after story, full of passion and struggle, with some help from AI along the way, of course. Now, I know what you're thinking. Okay, I see why Mike needed to struggle. Makes sense. What about me? Why should I struggle? Why is struggle going to be a good thing in my life? Well, I'll give you an example. Let's think about that smartphone sat in your pocket right now. That amazing device that 50 years ago, nobody would have believed was even possible. And what we don't see is the struggle behind it. In 1976, a young entrepreneur named Steve Jobs had an idea. Now, at the time, computers were big, heavy, bulky things that only company offices used, really. But Jobs had a crazy idea. He believed everybody should have a computer. But investors just weren't interested. He got rejection after rejection. But instead of giving up, Jobs decided to push back, to refine his ideas, to struggle. And through all of that struggle, we now have the company called Apple, which is one of the most influential in human history. No struggle, no growth. I'll give you another example of struggle. Perhaps you can also relate to this one. Let's think about the first time that you drive a car. Hands gripping the wheel, feet hovering over the pedals, all those controls in front of you, your fear, your doubt, that struggle to get it out onto the road. It's tough stuff. Now let's imagine you could skip all that. You could dump the driving lessons and just buy a self-driving car. No need to learn to judge distances, anticipate danger, make split-second decisions. Sounds convenient, but the truth is, if you never learn those skills, you're never going to truly learn to understand the road. And these are skills that are going to come in useful in all areas of your life later on, actually. No struggle, no growth. And I'll give you one final example. This is from my own life. Perhaps you can also relate to this one. It's 2007, and I decided to move to Japan. Now, I'd never even been to Japan before. Some of my friends told me I was crazy. And any of you who have ever moved to a foreign country before will know exactly what I'm talking about when I say struggle. I had no friends, no language skills, absolutely no understanding of the culture. I felt like a baby. And every day really was a struggle. And I had two choices. I could face those challenges one day at a time, or take shortcuts. Shortcuts like staying in an expat bubble and only speaking with English speakers. Shortcuts like avoiding Japanese classes and just using translation apps. Or just sticking to food that I know and never trying any of those weird-looking local dishes. And these shortcuts were tempting. But I knew taking those shortcuts would make me miss out on some really great opportunities, some real room for personal growth. So I decided to struggle. And through all of that struggle, through all of those embarrassing conversations and silly mistakes that I made every single day, I grew. And two decades later, I'm a happy, confident, curious member of the society. My struggle, my growth. So all of these stories and Mike's show us why struggle really matters. So students, do you want to live in City 1 and take all those shortcuts? Or City 2 with Mike and struggle your way to some real success? You're living in one of the most amazing times in human history, where AI is no longer science fiction. It's a real part of your daily lives. But this leaves you with a very big choice to make. Are you going to let AI do the thinking for you? Or are you going to use AI to push your thinking further than ever before? Nobody's saying don't use AI. Use it, play with it, learn with it. Just don't stop there. Question it, challenge it, build on it. The struggle you go through to create something truly original is where real progress happens. So, next time an assignment comes your way and you're tempted just to use AI to get a quick fix, pause. Ask yourself this. What do I think? What can I do that no machine ever could? And remember, no struggle, no growth. The future won't be built by the people in City 1 who take all those shortcuts. the future is going to be built by people like Mike in City 2, who keep thinking and keep struggling. So let's all move to City 2 together and enjoy that struggle. Thank you.